Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Molly. How are you?
I'm fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
I'm also fine. Super duper fine. Now, how is everyone at your house?
Yes, ma'am.
All okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so today shall we do, we have already completed one poem and one chapter, that is Monkey Trouble. So today shall we do Fight Manju Fight? Please unmute yourself. Please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, I'll take my book, ma'am.
Yes, please take your book. Okay, so shall we begin?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now we will study Fight Manju Fight. Now, this is a story of a young girl, Manju, who does not let adversities hamper her ambitious spirit. Now, what does adversities mean? Adversity means some type of challenging situations or some ups and downs in everybody's life is there. So, that was present in Manju's life and she did not let her demotivate her. Okay, she carried on with her ambition and it did not demotivate her. Okay, so let's begin. Manjula Parelkar knew she was no Hussein. She could never be, not with those hands of hers, those claw-like malformed fingers. Why her hands too, wasn't it enough that her feet were deformed, ending in a two massive moon-shaped toes pointing at each other, the hard nails touching, grating against each other whenever she wore wrong shoes. She wore wrong shoes most of the time, for there weren't any shoes in the market soft enough for her clumsy feet. Okay, now we are told about a young girl, Manju. Actually, her full name was Manjula, but as short, people used to call her Manju. And she tells that she liked painting, but she told that she was not like Hussein. Okay, he was a great artist. So she tells that she's not like him. Why? Because she even could not dream of becoming like him, because she had a deformity. She was a special child. Her hands and legs were malformed. Okay, it was deformed. The feet were also deformed, and the fingers were also deformed. So she was like, she had accepted that, but sometimes she used to feel bad about it. Okay. Her feet hurt most of the time, but she didn't mind them so much. She could hide them in those ugly made-to-order shoes, but she could not hide her hands, could she? So her feet used to hurt her, but what she could do was she had found a solution that she could hide her feet by wearing some ugly shoes, and because they were not, it was not shown. But how could she hide her hands? Her hand were always visible, and that she could not hide it. Okay. So she used to think about that, and all this shows us that obviously she was anxious about it. She was not so comfortable. Why? Because people might tease her or might give her glances, which made her uncomfortable. Sometimes even we get adjusted with what deformity we have, but the surrounding and the people in the surrounding force us again to feel that we are not perfect or we are not normal, and that really matters. So Manju tells us that the feet she could hide it, but her hands she could not, even though she wanted to, but she could not hide her hands. Okay, clear up till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Manjula knew she would never paint like Hussein, but she could learn to paint well. Handling brushes was no problem. They didn't feel any different from a pencil. Her problem was the cost of materials she would need. So she knew that she was not an artist. Okay. But then she also tells us that she could always learn to paint, and brushes, she compares the brushes with the pencil. And she tells us that holding a brush is like holding a pencil. So that will not be an issue for her. And the only problem was that because the painting materials and the paper, the canvas, the colors, and all those are really very costly. So the cost of the material was bothering her. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Mummy, she asked one evening while helping her mother in the kitchen after dinner, "Do you think I could?" She paused nervously. "I could have some extra money tomorrow." So one day, while after the dinner, she was helping her mother cleaning the dishes and all that. And then she was a bit nervous and anxious. And then she asked her mother that, "Mother, can you lend me some money?" It means she was hesitant. So she asked it twice. She took a pause and then she began that, can you lend me some extra money tomorrow? Then her mother says, "What do you need it for?" asked her mother, gently rinsing the dishes. So her mother was washing the dishes, and then her mother was very polite and gentle lady. You will read along when you see it. Her mother was very very motivating also. She always helped Manju. So her mother was a gentle, kind lady, and she told that, "What happened, my child? Why do you need the money? I will give you certainly, but can you tell me the reason that why do you need the money?" "For ice cream," answered her brother from the door, with an impish grin. Now see, younger siblings and children, they're always in the party mode, they're smiling. So the younger brother told that, "I'm sure she wants money to have an ice cream." And he was smiling. Okay. Thumping the door with the palm of his hand, he chanted, "We want ice cream, we want ice cream." So he told that, "Oh yes, we want ice cream, we want ice cream." And he made the sound with the door and he was enjoying himself. Ignoring him, her mother repeated, "Why do you need the money, Manjula?" So mother also knew that the younger brother will always behave like this. So she also ignored him. And then again she asked Manjula gently. Her mother was always gentle with her. Why? Because she was a special child. Sometimes, you know, children with special, like special children, they need special treatment, and they have also, their feelings are very, like, you know, they are very touchy. So we should always think before speaking to them, and we should be very courteous and polite with them. So her mother was a very sensible lady. She again asked Manjula politely that, "Can you please tell me that why do you need the money?" "For colors and paints. I want to learn painting." Now Manjula was also nervous and hesitant, and she was reluctant to say that, but somehow she was very close to her mother. So she told that, "Mother, I want money for colors and paints, and I want to learn painting. Okay, this is my hobby and I want to learn painting." "Painting?" asked her mother unbelievably. But you, she added quickly, "of course, it's nice hobby." So now see the pause her mother has used. Now mother also could not believe that she wants to learn painting. And then she says, "but," then there is dot, 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 and "you," dot, dot, dot. Then she changes her sentence. She modifies her sentence quickly. And then she says, "of course, it's a nice hobby." Then her mother says that, "oh, okay, it's all right. It is a good hobby. Everybody should have a hobby. Okay, I will surely try to manage some money for you." Okay, so up till here, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Mrs. Parlekar looked at her daughter searchingly. She gazed long into those serious, melancholy eyes. Closing the tap, she walked over to the kitchen cupboard and pulled out an ornate metal tea box from the topmost shelf. Now see, this is a very important paragraph. You mark it, put it in the brackets. Now see, her mother was, I told you previously also that her mother is an intelligent and very kind lady. Now when her daughter told her that, "Mother, I want to learn painting," she first looked at her daughter, and she looked at her daughter searchingly. Means she wanted to find that, really, my daughter has an hobby. Will she able to do it or not? Without any words, only the looks and glances were exchanged. She gazed long into those serious, melancholy eyes. Now, why Manjula's eyes are called serious and melancholy? Because already she has a deformed hand and a deformed feet, and that is why most of the time, obviously because of the surrounding, and see, when you are staying with the normal people, sometimes normal people don't realize it, and they hurt the special people, and the people with deform some problem. So what happened, Manjula was also sometimes, maybe this is not written in the text, but sometimes she might have been treated in that way. So her eyes are, see, we always say, no, the eyes are the mirror of the heart. So the eyes give the actual expression or the feelings of a person's heart. So when her mother looked at her and she saw that her eyes are sad and melancholy. Melancholy also means sadness. Okay. And then she really felt bad for her daughter. But all these things she did not tell her. She just went inside and she bought a metal tin box where she stored her money. And then she took out some money and gave it to Manjula. And that made Manjula very happy. So I told you previously also that we should have a sympathetic heart for people with some deformities. Okay, because they also try very hard. We have to understand them. Okay, clear, Moli, up till here?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me quickly, how was the class? How was today's class?
It was nice, ma'am.
Okay, so shall I end?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, bye.
Bye, ma'am.